A reading from the beginning of the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians. Paul and Timothy, slaves of Christ Jesus, to all the holy ones in Christ Jesus who are in Philippi with the bishops and deacons. Grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. I give thanks to my God at every remembrance of you, praying always with joy in my every prayer for all of you, because of your partnership for the gospel from the first day until now. I am confident of this, that the one who began a good work in you will continue to complete it until the day of Christ Jesus. It is right that I should think this way about all of you, because I hold you in my heart. You who are all partners with me in grace, both in my imprisonment and in the defense and confirmation of the gospel. For God is my witness, how I long for all of you with the affection of Christ Jesus. And this is my prayer, that your love may increase ever more and more in knowledge and in every kind of perception to discern what is of value, so that you may be pure and blameless for the day of Christ, filled with the fruit of righteousness that comes through Jesus Christ for the glory and praise of God. The word of the Lord. How great are the works of the Lord. How great are the works of the Lord. I will give thanks to the Lord with all my heart in the company and assembly of the just. Great are the works of the Lord, exquisite in all their delights. How great are the works of the Lord. Majesty and glory are his work, and his justice endures forever. He is one renowned for his wondrous deeds. Gracious and merciful is the Lord. How great are the works of the Lord. He has given food to those who fear him. He will forever be mindful of his covenant. He has made known to his people the power of his works, giving them the inheritance of the nations. How great are the works of the Lord.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. On a Sabbath, Jesus went to dine at the home of one of the leading Pharisees. And the people that were observing him carefully, in front of him there was a man suffering from dropsy. Jesus spoke to the scholars of the law, and the Pharisees replied, asking, "Is it lawful to cure the Sabbath or not?" But they kept silent. So he took the man, and after he had healed him, dismissed him. Then he said to them, "Who among you, if your son or not falls into sin, will not immediately pull him out on the Sabbath day?" But they were able to answer his question. The Gospel of the Lord. A short reflection for us this morning. As Paul speaks to his friends at the beginning of the letter to the Philippians, urging them to continue to do what the Lord has invited them to do, Paul says, "The good work the Lord has begun in you, he himself will bring it into fulfillment." Meaning to say, the mission of Paul and his friends were not something of their own, but rather it is something that God has begun in them. And for that mission to be fulfilled, does not so much depend upon them, but rather depends upon God himself, who will help them to bring that mission into fulfillment. And so Jesus brings this again in the Gospel this morning, when he goes to this place to pray, not just among the crowd and had a meal, but in the context of that dinner, he realized there was a man who needed to be healed. However, it happened to be on Sabbath, and ordinarily, as you know, the Jews didn't do anything on the Sabbath day because they don't know. And so Jesus poses this question: is it okay to heal this man today? And the scholars of the law, they did not answer that question. But what Jesus is driving out here is, the laws are good as long as they are beneficial to the human beings. It's not just the law for the sake of the law, but the law for the sake of us. And so he goes on and he will bring healing to this man. Told him, "You are healed," and so go on. What is he trying to show us is, Jesus came to do the will of his Father. In other words, the good work began in him by his Father. He will bring it to fulfillment. And that good work began in him does not depend on the laws, but rather depend on God himself. So again, it's a lesson for us, dear brothers and sisters, when it comes to doing something good to your brother or to your sister, it's not really so much about what does the Lord say, it's what does God want you to do. Because oftentimes we are so caught up by the laws, you know, we seem to care more about the regulations, about the laws, and sometimes less of what God is asking of us. Today, we are reminded from the first reading and also the gospel reading, is we have to ask ourselves, what does God want of me? It's not so much about the law, otherwise we become legalistic. But we are more called to do what God has invited each one of us to do. And that's why, as I say, Paul reminds us in the first reading that the good work the Lord has begun in you, he will bring it into fulfillment. It's not about the laws. It's about what God has begun in you in doing good. So, let us continue to pray and ask the Lord to give us the grace and strength we need in fulfillment of the holy work that he has begun in each one of us.
May the grace of this Eucharist help us bear good fruit in our lives. Let us pray to the Lord. For all civic leaders, may God provide them with the spiritual and practical resources necessary for their work to bring an end to violence. Let us pray to the Lord. For all who are sick or suffering from physical or mental illness, may Christ, the divine physician, grant them comfort and healing. Let us pray to the Lord. For ourselves and our families and loved ones, may the outpouring of the Holy Spirit upon us conform us evermore to the heart and mind of Christ. Let us pray to the Lord. For those who have died, and especially today for John D. Pietro Polo and Daniel and James Coogan, who remember at this Mass, may they soon gaze forever upon the face of God. Let us pray to the Lord. And for all those petitions we hold deep in our hearts, let us pray to the Lord.
Loving Father, hear our prayers and provide for our needs as you seek them. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Blessed are the Lord, and 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 the Voice in our land. Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold in him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy to be the gentle and the high roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be Christ loved us and gave himself up for us as a fragrant offering to God. Prayer for spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in this most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you to my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually to my heart.